My name is Ivannia Molina, labor law expert from BLP Costa Rica, and I will be sharing some important insights on digital nomads. Being a digital nomad has become increasingly prevalent globally, and Costa Rica is no exception. As in September 2021, the digital nomad law was approved, and in July 2022, the regulation for this law were also approved. Consequently, a digital nomad stay can be requested by individuals with flexible work conditions, and here are some of the requirements to opt out for this type of visa. The income requirement for individuals is of at least $3,000 per month over the past year. Also, for families, is of at least $4,000 per month, with the particularity that they can combine their incomes to meet this requirement. In either case, it is important for the income to continue being received even if the individuals are not in their home country. Obtaining a health insurance policy that covers the applicants for the entire duration of their stay in the country, and to make the one-time payment to the issuance of the non-resident visa as a remote worker or service provider. Being a digital nomad in Costa Rica offers several benefits, such as one-year extendable visa, recognition of driver's license, permission to open local bank accounts, the ability to stay in the country with your spouse and dependents, work for a company in other country without the need to be included in local payroll or pay local salary taxes, exemption from income tax, and duty-free importation of necessary teleworking equipment. Regarding employment, individuals under this status will not be able to engage in paid work or services within the national territory that are different from what is allowed under their specific migratory category as an international remote worker or freelancer. In conclusion, from a labor law perspective, Costa Rica offers several advantages and considerations for those digital nomads who are seeking a combination of legal compliance and favorable working conditions. If you would like to know more information about this, you can find my bio in the description below. Thank you for watching our Employment Matters blog. Remember to subscribe for current insights and updates on important global labor and employment topics presented by ELAP.